Let us see the important Indian Ramsar sites. There are altogether 37 as on April 2020. Today is the, we are in the month of April 2020. Today is 15th of April. As on 15th of April 2020, there are 37 Ramsar sites from India. The first one, let us talk about all these Ramsar sites. Question can be asked from these sites. The first one is called as Ashtamudi wetland. What is this Ashtamudi? Ashtamudi, the name symbolizes, the name Ashtamudi means 8 lakes. There are 8 lakes which are of backwaters. These are the backwaters of Kerala, where these are very important wetland. Suppose if this is Kerala, here in the district of Kollam, there is a district called as Kollam district of Kerala, where we need not even remember all these districts and all these things, but what you need to understand is when I am giving some extra explanation for this one, you can remember Ashtamudi is there in Kerala and it is related to the backwaters. This is the Ashtamudi lake which is present here in the Kerala. This is the second largest backwater lake of Kerala. This is the Ashtamudi, which is an important Ramsar site. The next one is called as the Bias Conservation Reserve, that is present here in Punjab. Bias Conservation Reserve is nothing but there is a river called as Bias River, over which you can find this particular the conservation reserve. This conservation reserve is housing a very important many important species, not just one important species. There it is housing many important species, therefore it is called as the internationally important conservation reserve. It's called as Bias Conservation Reserve in the state of Punjab. Then the next one, which is a very important one, is called as the Bitter Kanika Mangroves. The Bitter Kanika Mangroves, which are located in the state of Orissa, the importance of this mangrove area is this is the India's second largest mangrove after Sundarbans of West Bengal. At the same time, the important species in this Bitter Kanika mangrove region are the saltwater crocodiles, and the very important species is called as the monitor lizard. These are the two very important endemic species you can find here in this wetland. Also, very close to this Bitter Kanika wetland region, you can find other very important area is called as Gahir Mata. Gahir Mata is a again protected area. It's called as the Gahir Mata Wildlife Sanctuary, a very important protected area which is having a very good biodiversity here in this region. Gahir Mata can be a question, Bitter Kanika can be a question, all they are there in the state of Orissa. This is about the Bitter Kanika. Then moving to the next one, which is a very important wetland of Madhya Pradesh called as Bhoj Wetland. The Raja of Bhoj, he has constructed the Bhoj Wetland. In this one, where the in the Bhoj Wetland, the river that is draining here is called as Kolan River. The name of the river that is draining in the Bhoj Wetland is the Kolan River. Raja of Bhoj has constructed this one. There are in fact two lakes for this Bhoj wetland. Suppose if this is a wetland, there are two. One is called as the Upper Bhoj and the one is the Lower Bhoj. Upper Bhoj is exclusively meant for irrigation purposes, whereas the Lower Bhoj is meant for the drinking purpose. It is what the Raja has charted the plan to develop this wetland on these lines. This is a very important wetland of Madhya Pradesh, Bhoj. Then the next wetland which is located in the Himachal Pradesh is Chandratal. What is the importance of this Chandratal? This is the smallest of all the wetlands of India. It is just 0.2 square kilometers. This is the smallest of all the wetlands of India, located here in the Himachal Pradesh. The name of this wetland is called as Chandra Tal. Then the Chilka Lake. Chilka Lake is the largest saline lake of India, which is also called as lagoon. It's called as Chilka Lagoon, which is located in the state of Odisha. This is located in two districts. It means what? Overlapped into two districts. One is called as the Puri River, Puri district, and the Ganjam district. The rivers that flows into this one are the Daya River and Bhargavi River. The two rivers that are flowing into this one are the Daya River and the Bhargavi River. Let me write the names of these two rivers. One is called as Daya River, DAYA. Other one is called as Bhargavi River. BHARGAVI, Bhargavi River. These are two rivers where they flow into this Chilka Lake. And again, very important point regarding this Chilka. Suppose if this is a Chilka Lake, this is the coastline. Suppose if this is a Chilka Lake, in the middle of the Chilka Lake, you can find a small island. The name of the island is called as Nalbana Island. It's called as Nalbana, L-A-N-B-A-N-A. This is the Nalbana Nalbana Island, B-A-N-A, Nalbana Island. This Nalbana Island is a bird sanctuary. Again, it's very, very important. Also, there is another important area which is called as Mangala Jodi. It's called as Mangala Jodi. M-A-N-G-A-L-A-J-O-D-I. All they are associated with the Chilka Lake. Mangala Jodi is a place very near to the Chilka Lake. It is famous for birds. All the Nalbana is a bird sanctuary, and then is Mangala Jodi region is a very important protected area for the birds. These are all the very important region. These are the very important wetlands that are present here in Orissa. Also, one more point, let us add one more point for Chilka. What is the unique nature of this Chilka? The marine life that is present here in Chilka is unique. Why? Because of one very important migratory species called as Irrawaddy dolphin. There is a dolphin called as Irrawaddy dolphin. I-R-R-A-W-A-D-Y. Irrawaddy dolphins. What is Irrawaddy? Irrawaddy is a name of a river in Myanmar, where the Irrawaddy River drains into Bay of Bengal, at the mouth of Bay of Bengal, where right from the river the dolphins comes here into this mouth, into the Bay of Bengal. From there they migrate towards the Chilka Lake. This is the area where the Irrawaddy dolphins comes all the way from the mouth of Irrawaddy River towards India. These are the important points which are associated with the Chilka Lake. The next important wetland is Dipur Bil, which is located in the state of Assam. This Dipur Bil is a very important lake which is having connectivity with the river called as Brahmaputra. That means what? The waters of Brahmaputra are draining into this lake. The importance of this lake, Dipur Bil. Bil is nothing but lake in the local language. There is an important bird here in this region called as the white stork. It's called as white stork. Not stork, it's called stork. S-T-O-R-K. It's a wild stork. This is a very important species that is present here in this Dipur Bil. Because of this one, one of the criteria has been satisfied, and due to this white stork only, where the Dipur Bil became the important wetland in the Ramsar Convention, which is located here in the state of Assam. In the local language, where the Assami people, these people called Assami people were the communities like Bodo community and some other communities where these people call this water body as Deepurbil. What is the meaning of this one? Is nothing but it's a lake of elephants. It's a lake of elephants, which is located within the city of Guwahati. Very close to Guwahati city, the capital city of Assam, where you can find the Deepurbil. The next one is called as East Kolkata Wetland. This East Kolkata Wetland is located very close to Kolkata. This is a man-made wetland. What is the importance of this one? This is a man-made wetland. The people have developed this wetland not for protecting the birds or marine species, but this very wetland is meant for treating the seaways. This wetland is basically constructed due to the treatment of seaways that is coming from the Kolkata city. But this very region, because of the treating of the seaways, where the residue material that has been obtained here from this one is acting as a feed for fishes. Therefore, you can find huge quantity of fish is present here. This is the seaways, the residue is acting as a manure for the fishes. The area that is present here, the fishing ground that is present here, is called as Dheri, D-H-E-R-I. This is the fishing ground that is present here within this East Kolkata wetland. This is about the East Kolkata wetland. The next one, which is a very, very important one, is called as Harike wetland. Harike wetland is present in the state of Punjab. What is the importance of this Harike? Harike is a place where you can find the confluence of two rivers. One, Satluj. The name of the river is called as Satluj. The another river is called as Bias River. Bias joins into Satluj at a place called as Harike. This is Harike. This is the place where you can find the confluence of the two rivers. Not only this one, from here you can find the construction of the man-made river called as the Indira Gandhi Canal. This is the Harike, very, very important wetland, which is very close to the very mighty city called as the Amritsar, very important and the pious city called as Amritsar. This is what the Harike wetland. Then the next one is called as Hokhara wetland. This Hokhara wetland is located in the Union Territory of Jammu Kashmir. It's the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. This is again a very important wetland that is present here in the Jammu Kashmir. What is the importance of this Hokhara wetland? It is very close to Srinagar, the capital city of Kashmir, very close to Srinagar. This is the wetland that is present called as Hokhara wetland. The next one, Khanjli wetland, again very important. Khanjli wetland is present in the state of Punjab. This Khanjli wetland, which is on the river, the name of the river is called as Kali Bin. The name of the river is called as Kali Bin, B-E-A-N. This Kali Bin is a tributary for the river Bias. On this Kali Bin, you can find the Khanjli wetland. It is believed that the great pious personality Guru Nanak got enlightened on the banks of this Khanjli Bin, and the very sacred guru of one of the guru of Sikh community, where he is having his ashram on the banks of this Kali Bin. This, the name of that very pious personality is Balbir Singh Sichawal. The name of this personality is Balbir Singh. Balbir Singh Sichawal. Why we need to read this personality? Why? Because what he did, he has taken a very great activity to clean this wetland. In fact, he has asked all his followers to clean the entire Kalibeen river, and because of the best efforts made by the people here, this wetland is not in a degraded condition right now. Because of the invasive species like water hyacinth, where the entire wetland is highly degraded here. Not even a single migratory bird used to come here, but right now, because of the best efforts made by these people, at least you can find a few birds which are coming from different parts of the world are can be seen here in this region. This is the Kanjli wetland. The last one in this clipping is the Keladio National Park. Again, already we have discussed this one very briefly. What is this Keladio National Park? In fact, this national park, within this national park, you can find the lake called as Keladio Lake. This is an artificial lake on the confluence of two rivers, not confluence exactly, where there are two rivers there that are flowing into this lake. One is called as Banganga, B-A-N-G-A-N-G-A. One is Banganga. Another one is called as Gambhir River, G-A-M-B-H-I-R. These are the two rivers which flows into this lake is called as Keladio Lake. This is the lake which was constructed by the Raja of Bharatpur. Since it is located in the Bharatpur district of Rajasthan, the Raja of Bharatpur has constructed this lake so that he can go for the time pass activity to hunt the birds. This is the story behind the Keladio. Even today, this Keladio lake is in a highly degraded condition, therefore it is enlisted in the Montreux record. Which of the following lake or the wetland is still now in the Montreux record? It is the Bharatpur Lake, otherwise called as the Keladio Lake or the Keladio National Park. This is the one where it is still date, it is in the Montreux record. The next one is Keshavpur. This is again very, very important. This Keshavpur Community Reserve, which is again located in the state of Punjab. In fact, this Keshavpur wetland is the first community reserve. What do you mean by community reserve? In the other video, we have already discussed the very important reserves like conservative reserve and the community reserve. What are these two reserves? Again, let us have a refreshment of these two. Suppose if this is a protected area, maybe a national park, maybe a wildlife sanctuary, or maybe a biosphere. Again, this is another protected area. Because of having two closely associated protected areas, the land between these two needs to be protected. If the land that is present in between these two protected area is under the control of the government, such land, such a protected area is called as conservation reserve. If this very land which is present between the two protected area is under the private ownership, where it is called as community reserve. And the Keshavpur is a very important community reserve in the state of Punjab. This is about the Keshavpur community reserve. The next one, Kulleru Lake. Kulleru Lake is a very important freshwater lake of Andhra Pradesh. Where you can find here, suppose if this is the coastal Andhra, it is located in the inland, in between the districts of Krishna and West Godavari. This is a very important lake of Andhra Pradesh, which is located in the coastal belt between the districts of Krishna and Godavari. In this Kulleru Lake, you can find the draining of waters of two rivers. Too small, it should not be called as rivers. In fact, they are the smaller streams coming into this Kolleru lake, one is called as Thammileru. This called as one is a very very small stream called as Thammileru stream. Another one, the another very small stream you can find here into this one is Budameru, Budameru. Budameru. No need to remember such a micro level things, but you can call this one as the Kolleru one is a freshwater lake that is present in Andhra Pradesh, which is a house for many migratory species. This is about the Kolleru lake. And what is the importance of this one? There are good number of aquacultural activities here. Aquacultural activities. In fact, the people of this region are basically depending upon this lake due to, for the aquaculture. The next one, Loktak. A very very important one is the Loktak. Let us move to the Loktak lake. Then the very important wetland here is called as the Kabul Lamjau. What is this Kabul Lamjau and why it is still now in the Montrex record? It is located in the state of Manipur. In fact, this is the Loktak, is the largest lake of the northeastern India. It is a freshwater lake. At the same time, within the lake, suppose if this is a lake where there is a falling of the vegetation, because of the falling of the vegetation, where you can find the floating vegetation here, where the grass will be grown here and it has been floating right from the depth of this lake till the upper reaches. Due to this one, where this floating vegetation by the it is called by the local people as Pumdis. What are Pumdis? Pumdis are nothing but the floating vegetation that is found in the Loktak lake. Because of the floating vegetation, nothing but Pumdis, you can find certain species resting here in the Pumdis. The name of the species is called as Sangai deer. This is called as Sangai deer. This Sangai deer is otherwise called as dancing deer. Why it is called as dancing deer? Whenever you are seeing the deer, as the deer is walking on the Pumdis, which is simply the floating material, as it can't place its leg very firmly, therefore whenever you are seeing from far distance, the deer appears to be dancing. This is why it's called as the dancing deer. And this is the only floating national park. The name of the national park is called as the Kabul Lamjau National Park, which is located in the Loktak Lake. The Kabul Lamjau National Park is because of Pumdis, nothing but floating vegetation. This is a very important national park in the Loktak Lake. The name of the species is Sangai deer, otherwise called as dancing deer. The next one is called as Nal Sarovar Bird Sanctuary. This the only Ramsar site that is present here in the state of Gujarat is Nal Sarovar. It's called as Nal Sarovar Bird Sanctuary. This is the very important bird sanctuary of Gujarat. The next one is called as, again, the only wetland in the state of Maharashtra is Nandur Madameshwar. Again, it's very important. It is announced in the year 2020. The first Ramsar site of Maharashtra is Nandur Madameshwar, announced in the year 2020. The next one is called as Nangal Wildlife Sanctuary. This is again announced in the year 2020. This is in the state of Punjab. This is nothing but Nangal, nothing but Bakra Nangal, where you are, the people are quite aware of this dam called as Bakra Nangal. One of the, whenever we listen that word Bakra Nangal, we feel like this is one dam. In fact, on the river Sutlej, there is a dam that was constructed, is called as Bakra Dam. To the lower reaches, there is another dam constructed called as Nangal Dam. In between these two, there is a distance of almost some 13 kilometers. As they are located on the same river, Sutlej River, and they are constructed both in association, therefore, the dam is called as Bakra Nangal. They are not just one, it is not just one dam, in fact, there are two dams. Therefore, near the Nangal, you can find the wildlife sanctuary, which is again the Ramsar wetland. This is located in the state of Punjab. The next one is called as Nawabganj Bird Sanctuary. Again, it is announced in the year 2020. It is in the state of Uttar Pradesh. Then Parvati Agra Bird Sanctuary. Again, it is recently announced. All the bird sanctuaries that are announced recently. In fact, in the year 2020, 10 new Ramsar sites were announced. Of this one, 6 are from UP. 1 from Maharashtra and remaining 3 from Punjab. This is the division where the 10 new Ramsar sites which are announced in the year 2020, 6 are from UP, 1 from Maharashtra, 3 from Punjab. Then the older one, the Point Calimere. The Point Calimere Wildlife Sanctuary and even the Bird Sanctuary. Suppose if this is Tamil Nadu, this is Sri Lanka, this is the area where it's called as Point Calimere. This point is very important, where you can find very important mangroves that are present here. The mangroves called as the Pichavaram mangroves that are present here. Again, this is a very important wetland of Tamil Nadu. The only wetland of Tamil Nadu is the Point Calimere wetland. The next one is called as the Pong Dam. The Pong Dam that is present here in the Himachal Pradesh is an artificial dam which is constructed on the river called as the Bias River. Then again, within the Himachal Pradesh, there is another wetland which is called as Renuka wetland. Renuka Mata, who is this Renuka Mata? There is a shrine called as Renuka Mata Shrine. In fact, Renuka is the mother of Parashuram. In the mythology, you come across this personality, Parashuram, where Parashuram's mother is Renuka. For this Renuka Mata, there is a temple here in the Himachal Pradesh, and this is a smaller water body, which is a very important for the birds. The birds are, it is a house of many species, especially birds are present here. And this one is called as the Renuka Wetland. This is about the Renuka wetland of Himachal Pradesh. Also, you can find the next one. The next one is the Roper wetland in Punjab. Altogether, there are 6 wetlands from Punjab, 7 from Uttar Pradesh. See, this you need to remember. There are 7 Ramsar sites from Uttar Pradesh, 6 are from Punjab. One of the very important one from Punjab is the Roper wetland that is present in the Roopnagar. The name of the name of the region is called as the Roopnagar, which is very close to the Chandigarh of Punjab, which is located on the river called as Sutlej. This is the Roper wetland. The next one is the Rudrasagar Lake in the state of Tripura. What is the importance of this Rudrasagar Lake? This is a very important one. What is the importance of this one, Rudrasagar? Suppose this is the Rudrasagar Lake. In the middle of the Rudrasagar, there is a small island on which Maharaja of Agartala, where he constructed a palace, a very important palace was being constructed, and this is the area, is the summer vacation for this Raja. This entirely the lake called as Rudrasagar Lake. which is again housing many migratory species here. This is an important wetland. Here itself we can find wildlife sanctuary called as Gumti. The important wildlife sanctuary here is called as the Gumti Wildlife Sanctuary, through which there is a river called as Gumti is flowing. You need to remember this one, Gumti River, Gumti Wildlife Sanctuary, which is associated with Rudrasagar wetland in the state of Tripura, close to Agartala. Okay, this is about the Rudrasagar. Then Saman Bird Sanctuary, again it was announced recently. Again recently, this one, Samaspur Bird Sanctuary. Samaspur Bird Sanctuary, Saman Bird Sanctuary, both are there in the Uttar Pradesh. Then Sandi Bird Sanctuary, again 2020. Saras Nawab, 2020. These are the four very important bird sanctuary. In fact, in the 2020, they have announced 10 via Ramsar sites. All the 10 are bird sanctuaries. One is Saman Bird Sanctuary, Samaspur Bird Sanctuary, Sandi Bird Sanctuary, and Sarsai Nawar Zil Bird Sanctuary. These are all the four very important bird sanctuaries of Uttar Pradesh, announced recently in the year 2020. The next one is called as the Sambar Lake. What is the importance of the Sambar Lake? This is the important largest saline lake in India. Largest saline lake. See, while discussing Chilka, we said that it is the largest saline lake of India. Again, while discussing the Sambar Lake, I am telling the same thing like largest saline lake. But the question is, which is the largest one? When you are talking about the inland and the coastal, Chilka is the coastal largest saline lake. Whereas the inland largest saline lake is Sambar, which is located in the state of Rajasthan. This is the Sambar Lake. This is the largest saline lake of Rajasthan. Very shallow lakes, which is located in the district of the district here is Nagaur district. N-A-G-O-U-R, Nagaur district. This is about the some of the important wetlands. Then moving to the next wetland. The next one is called as the Sastamkota wetland. The Sastamkota wetland is present here in the Kerala. Again, the Sastamkota is located in the district called as Kollam. Very close to the Sastamkota, you can find the Ashtamudi wetland. Again, this is also there in the Kollam, the district of Kollam. This is the Sastamkota wetland that is present here in the state of Kerala. Then Sundarbans. See, the Sundarbans wetland of West Bengal announced in the year 2019, and this is the 27th wetland. On 2nd February 2019, this was announced as the 27th wetland. Earlier there were just 26 wetlands. Now with the announcement of Sundarban wetlands, the list became 27. Then in the year 2020, 10 more added, totaling to 37. The 27th is Sundarban. Then Surisar Mansar Lake. Surisar Mansar Lake is a very important lake that is present here in the Jammu and Kashmir. This is near the Udhampur. This is called as Udhampur. It is in the district of Udhampur. Surisman Mansar. There is a big mythological story that is related with the Surisar Mansar, where once upon a time one of the Pandava called as Arjuna has pierced the arrow into the land for the sake of water, therefore the lake has developed. This is what something the story is there behind this Surisar Mansar. This is in the district of Udhampur of Jammu and Kashmir. Then Somoriri, again very important saline lake, the saline water lake called as Somoriri. So in the local language means what? Lake is located in the Union Territory of Ladakh. Somorodi Lake, where the very important point you need to remember here in the Somorodi Lake is, there is a bird that is associated with this lake called as the black-necked crane. Black-necked crane. This is a highly endemic species. Nowhere else in the world you can find this black-necked crane except in the Somorodi Lake. This is also, this lake is a very sacred lake for Buddhism, Buddhist people. In fact, Ladakh is completely dominated by Buddhism, and for the Buddhist people, this lake is a so sacred lake. This is about the Somorodi wetland. Then Upper Ganga. Upper Ganga is the bridge guard to Narora stretch. In fact, this is the first wetland of Uttar Pradesh, which was earlier announced. Earlier, there was just one wetland in Uttar Pradesh. In the year 2020, 6 were added, making the list to 7. Means what? Whenever there is a question that comes regarding the Uttar Pradesh, you need to remember just one wetland of Uttar Pradesh, which is called as Upper Ganga wetland. This Upper Ganga wetland is a older, the past wetland, and whatever the wetland that comes in the Uttar Pradesh, all blindly go, blindly say that they are the newly added wetlands. But you need to remember this one. If you remember this one, no need to remember the other 6. This is about the bridge guard to Narora stretch. This is on the Upper Ganga side. This is the first wetland of Uttar Pradesh. Then the next, which is very important one, is called as Vembanad wetland. This Vembanad is the one of the longest lake of India. One of the longest lake of India. Also the largest backwater lake of Kerala. Backwater of Kerala. This is the Vembanad Lake. Here in the Vembanad Lake, what is the importance of this Vembanad Lake? How to remember? During certain occasion, maybe during the festival time period, these people will be going for some race, where their race is called as the boat race. What is the name of this boat race called as Snake Boat Race? Where the boat is elongated boat is there, number of people will be sitting on the boat and they'll be rowing at a time. They'll be rowing at a time and the boat will be moving. This is what the boat race festival that is that takes place in the Vembanad Lake. Okay, this is about the Vembanad Lake that is present here in the Kerala. The last one is called as Ullar Lake. What is the importance of the Ullar Lake? Ullar Lake is the largest. This is the largest freshwater lake of India. This is the largest freshwater lake of India, located in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. It has formed due to the river called as Zelum. In fact, it is a oxbow lake. It's a oxbow lake. Whenever the river is meandering, the moment when the meander gets cut off, the river moves like this, straight. These waters remain as a lake. Such lake is called as Oxbow Lake, and Ullar is a one such lake. And again, it's a very important Ramsar site. These are all the important Ramsar wetlands of India. With this, we completed the Ramsar Convention and the Ramsar Wetlands in India. Need to pay very great attention regarding Montreux Record, then the three pillars of Ramsar Convention, then criteria, no need to remember, no need to remember what are the criteria and all these things. Then you need to remember the 37 wetlands, in which state, which wetland is located. They may be asking some specific species that are migratory in nature, or the species that are present in that wetland, or the importance of the wetland, in which year, that in which area that particular wetland and which state that particular wetland is located. This is all about the wetlands of India. Take care. Bye-bye.